Hello everyone. In the previous two sessions of paper 3, that is physiology, biochemistry and immunology, we have discussed about the osmoregulations. So in osmoregulation we have studied different types of solutions and what do you mean by osmosis and what do you mean by osmoregulators and osmoconformers, and main very important about osmoregulation in different types of fishes. So in this session mainly we'll discuss about osmoregulation of mammals. So coming to that, the osmoregulation in mammals, so we all know that even mammals, they are highly adaptive animals when compared to the different types of animals like reptiles and fishes and all, because they can live in different habitat and they can regulate their body temperature, and hence they are having homeostatic actions. So in osmoregulation in mammals, so as we have studied, what do you mean by osmoregulation? The regulation of constant volume and salt concentration of the body fluid is called as osmoregulation. So mammals are the perfect terrestrial animals because they live in different types of environment, as I have said, and they usually also live in different types of habitat like scarcity of water, and also they maintain constant volume and salt concentration of their body fluids. So they are called as homeoosmotic animals. Very, very important why mammals are called as homeoosmotic animals. So due to the scarcity of water and due to the uptake of salt and concentration of the volume, and they maintain their constant body fluids, that is how they are called as homeoosmotic animals. Hence they are also called as osmotically stable animals. So they have their ability to regulate the volume and salt concentration of the body fluid either by losing and gaining the water. So hence they are also called as osmoregulators. We'll see in what process they lose the water and gain the water. So usually the loss of water may be by high temperature due to evaporation, and excess of water is thrown out by the form of urine, and also our fecal matter, it also consists of water content. And due to respiration, the high respiration, the amount of water which is present inside our body, it is also exchanged through the environment, the sweating, and also for the metabolic activities. So these are the processes how water is lost in mammals. But how, in what way it is gained? So usually it is gained by drinking, or maybe by food, maybe by metabolic water, and water absorbed from the urine. So inside the PCT, that is, you have studied the structure of proximal convoluted tibule, PCT, the section of your nephron, so there the water will be reabsorbed. So these are the two means how water is lost and water is gained. So very important in this, we'll be discussing about desert kangaroo rat and camel. So usually in your syllabus about the mammals, they will ask about the example, they will give the example and they will ask you to write the mechanism how they overcome the regulation in different types of habitats. So in detail we'll see the mechanism how the mammals overcome their osmoregulation. So first one, that is prevention of evaporation. So as we all know that in the desert, during the daytime the conditions are very hot and night the conditions are cold. So but what happens, the mammals lose water to evaporation due to the high environmental temperature. So they have layers of epidermal keratin. So this thick keratin layer, it will prevent evaporation, and their body is also covered with thick hairs. So due to that, the mammals overcome the evaporation. When coming to the desert mammals, they select shady places during the daytime to minimize the evaporation. So the desert kangaroo rat remains inside the burrow during the daytime to avoid evaporation. This is how the kangaroo rat overcome the prevention of the evaporation. Next, we'll see reduced glomerular filtration. So in your lower classes, if you have studied the structure of the nephron, there the structure of glomerular filtration takes place. So there the mammals produce the minimal amount of glomerular filtrate, because the water which is present within the body, it will be reabsorbed inside their body to reduce the glomerular filtration. So there the anatomical kidney, if you see the structure of the kidney or compared to different types of animals, there the glomerular filtration will be reduced. Coming to third one, that is production of hyperosmotic urine. So if they are living in desert condition, they has to secrete concentrated urine, because if the diluted urine, if they are secreting, the loss of water will be excess through the urine also. That is why they will produce hyperosmotic urine. The urine has to be more salt concentrated than the blood. And also the animals inhabit dry environment due to the qualities of extremely concentrated urine. And as I was telling, the anatomy of the kidney or the nephron structure will be reduced. That is, endless loop of the nephron act as the osmostat, and it adjusts the concentration of the urine. That is how they overcome the production of hyperosmotic urine, and they overcome osmoregulation. So along with that, and usually the rodents like mammals which are present, they are having long Henle's loop, and some are having the short Henle's loop. The urine of kangaroo rat is twice concentrated as the laboratory rat and three times concentrated as the dog. Then think how much the urine will be concentrated, and the amount of urine secreted will be very less. So this is the example for the overcoming or the hypoosmotic condition. Next, utilization of metabolic water. So we all know that desert animals like camel and kangaroo rat, they utilize the water which is derived from the metabolism. For example, the breaking of food material, usually they take high protein rich diet. So that what happens? The breaking of the food, it will take a longer time, and hence they can also overcome starving. So that is why they can utilize the metabolic water for different purposes. And next one, reabsorption of water from the urine. So in mammals, usually large amount of water is reabsorbed from the urine. So as I was telling about the PCT, that is proximal convoluted tubule, and collecting duct of the nephron. So here what happens? The urine become less in volume and it will be more concentrated. So you can write many these type of techniques to overcome reabsorption or the osmoregulation of mammals, or the, if they are giving the example like desert kangaroo rat or camel, so you can write these mechanisms. And as I was telling, the utilizing fat rich food related, they consume dry seeds, and reabsorption of water of fecus also takes place. And ureotelism, this is very important. So what do you mean by ureotelism? So as in your lower classes, you have studied about the nitrogenous excretion. There are three types: urotelic, uricotelic, and aminotelic. So aminotelic means ammonia secreting, uricotelic means uric acid, ureotelic means they secrete urea. So usually these organisms, they excrete urea, and they convert ammonia into urea. The excretion of ammonia requires maximum of water, but the excretion of urea needs minimum amount of water. That is why they become ureotelic. And also the absence of sweat glands, it is also very much important physiological action. So usually they don't have sweat glands. That is how they do not sweat, and the water can be conserved for their metabolic action. And also the camel use its sweat glands for regulating the body temperature. So during daytime the temperature will be very much high. So that is how they regulate the body temperature by using, or they will use sweat glands. And next, tolerance to the temperature fluctuation. So usually the camel can withstand up to 6.5 degrees Celsius fluctuations, But we human beings, if there is 1 degree increase in the normal environment, our body temperature will rise or body temperature decreases, or due to that type of reactions, we may get ill. So this is called as hypothermal condition. So during daytime, that will be very much high, but during night, the camel allows the body temperature to fall. So that is called as hypothermia. Hypo means less. So during daytime, what happens? It raises the body temperature, and they without operating the thermoregulatory devices. So we all know that thermoregulation takes place by different types of receptors, and this tolerance of temperature, it also helps in conserving water. And minimal use of thermoregulatory mechanisms. So here, what they will do, it consists both of kangaroo rat and camel. So here I have explained related to kangaroo rat. So through lungs and skin, they reduce evaporation and concentrated urine, dry fecus, and they are having high tolerance to heat, and they are nocturnal. As I have said, they go in burrows during the daytime, and they only during the nighttime they will be activated. And camel, they live for months together without water because they can store the water in their hump region, and also they obtain water from oxidation of fat stored in the hump, and also during the metabolism they can store water, and they are having very much power to withstand dehydrated, and also they can reduce sweating because the presence of no sweat glands, or they don't have the sweat glands. At last, the secretion of concentrated milk. So this will be taking place in whales because high amount of fat will be present in the milk. So if the fat is less and the water will the milk contain high amount of water, so and milk will be less concentrated. So in usually whales and all, the high concentrated milk will be produced. And hormonal mechanism, so the hormones which are secreted by the pituitary, adrenal and parathyroid glands, they convert, they control or also they convert the water regulations. So that is how the osmoregulation takes place in mammals. So in this session, complete osmoregulation in mammals comparative to the kangaroo rat or the desert kangaroo rat and camel can be asked for your examination point of view. So that is about this session. Thank you.